Hey, what's going on YouTube? I'm really glad to meet you all once again with another exciting video. Before getting into the video, let me confess, this video is going to be one among the plenty of how-to videos out there. But I can assure you, it's going to be a little different. Also, it is going to be very useful for you, particularly the people who are preparing networks and penetration testing, ethical hacking, CTF players, and many others indeed. Whatever technology we study, we first worry the study content, the study materials. We always have concern to get good study material. But apart from the study material, we do have one more concern. Labbing. We always think about good labs. For example, let's take networking. If you want to learn networking as a beginner, you may use Cisco Packet Tracer. And beyond the beginner level, you may use GNS3 or even G. Here, we are going to talk about one of the such simulators. Excuse me, emulators. The name is PNet Lab. Compared with GNS3 and even G, the PNet Lab is not familiar that much. But feature-wise, in my experience, I'm saying this, PNet Lab stands tall compared with GNS3 and even G. Let me show you the complete installation of PNet Lab. Okay, first, the prerequisites part. And this is my machine specification. I have 8 GB RAM and i5 processor. This is more than enough to run moderate labs. Besides the system requirements, you need to enable few other features and the features are virtual machine platform and Windows subsystem for Linux. Make sure these two options are enabled. Then only the virtual machine will work. Also, in BIOS window, the virtualization technology has to be enabled. So make sure that the installation part would be similar to even G. Let's do it. First, we need the VMware workstation player. Let's download that. VMware Workstation Player is totally free for non-commercial purpose. Individuals can download it and use it for labbing. The download has finished. Let's install. Here comes the next part. Let me choose the path. I don't need this. Now the VMware player is being installed and it will create the virtual network adapters. So we need to wait for a couple of minutes. Yes, it is done. You can skip the license part. Yes, it is done. Let's verify whether the adapters are created or not. It's a virtual adapter. Let's make sure. Yes, the virtual adapters created as expected. These are the virtual adapter created by the VMware. Okay, it's time to run the workstation player. Non-commercial purpose, so I'm giving continue. Yes. We successfully launched our virtual machine. So it's a hypervisor. So it will be running on my Windows operating system. And on this hypervisor, we can able to install various operating system. So on this hypervisor, we are going to install our P Peanut Lab. Let's visit the damn Peanut Lab website. Go through this website. Here are the features. These features are really exciting. Why I am saying Peanut Lab is better than EvenG? Because Peanut Lab provides more features than EvenG. If you earn those features in the EvenG, then you have to subscribe the EvenG Pro. But Peanut Lab, it is totally free. That is the excellent thing. And also, the Peanut Lab has online store where the pre-designed labs are available. You can download the labs simply and you can work those labs. Go through the documentation. It will be useful when you are configuring and when you are using the Peanut Lab. Now it is time to download it. Its size is around 2 GB. I have downloaded the Peanut Lab image. Now, from the workstation player, let's call the Peanut Lab image. Open the virtual machine and you will get the OVA file. Simply import the file. And you need to choose the lab location. The image is successfully imported. Let's customize the virtual machine setting. I'm giving processor as 6. And you need to check this option, virtualize Intel VT. Yes. And the hard disk is 100 GB, which is more than enough. And network adapter, I'm choosing as my VM8. It is NAT adapter. One is enough. It's time to spin up the machine. Yes, it got the IP. The username is root and the credential is pnet. It is almost similar to EvenG, but it gives us some additional features. And the root password. I'm choosing DHCP. And rest of the configuration, I keep it as default. Let's try this URL from the browser. Yes, we got it finally. Excuse me. The credential is admin. And the password is pnet. I'm choosing HTML console. We can avail both HTML and default console. Now we have the lab environment. Here we can create . So this is our lab workspace. This is where we are going to spin up our devices. And we are going to lab. Let's see what are the devices out there in the lab. I'm just clicking right click and node. Virtual PC, just a default PC, like a terminal. You don't get a GUI in this PC. It's just a terminal, which will be helpful for you to check the basic utilities like ping, trace routes. See another device, Docker. This is what an additional feature which is not available in Eve Community Edition, but it is available in PNet Lab. The PNet Lab is totally free. You can use the Docker machines in our lab. Let me show you how to add Docker machines in our lab. Let's close this lab. In the home page, you need to click devices. Here you can see the list of available Docker containers. We can add the Wireshark Docker device and the Chrome, Ubuntu server, and also Ubuntu desktop. And excitingly, we have Ansible Docker instance. We can spin up this Ansible instance and we can parallelly spin up our network devices and we can enforce the automation. And these Ubuntu desktops and servers are lightweight instances. Also, you can use these instances for your penetration testing. If you are a CTF player, you can also use this. And in order to add the Docker images, you simply need to click the Get device. I'm just getting the Chrome instance now, the Docker instance. It will take a couple of minutes to download the Docker instance. Now you can see the status got changed. The Docker image added to the PNet lab. Now we can use this Docker image in our lab. Let's spin up the lab and use the Docker image that we downloaded. I chose Docker, and here we need to choose the Docker image. I'm choosing Chrome because so far Chrome only I downloaded. If you download other Ubuntu instances, Ansible instances, then you will get the listings here. I'm choosing the Chrome instance, and 250 MB is enough, and ETH1 DHCP. I'm choosing this one. I'll tell you how my instance is going to get the IP address. I'm simply saving it. Now, the Docker instance is alone. It's a Chrome instance. Why don't we give the internet connectivity to this instance? For that, you have to click the network. In network, we have the management, Cloud Zero interface. So this cloud, this network is connected with management zero interface, and that management zero interface is nothing but the NAT interface we chose in the custom configuration of this machine. My private Wi-Fi range is different from this range because this lab is connected in NAT with my original Wi-Fi network. Let's start this Docker instance. Oh, I need to choose RDP instead Telnet. Now I got connected with my Chrome Docker image. Let me connect. From here, I can connect with internet. So we can use this Docker image to check the internet connectivity. We can use it for browsing purpose. I'm just giving a small example. We can use this Docker instance behind any network device and we can do some configurations in those devices and we can check how the traffic is flowing when we are initiating the traffic from this Docker instance. Let's stop it. Another exciting feature is startup configuration pushing. Here we can add multiple startup configuration. startup one. When you see that, when you click the drop-down list, you will find the startup configuration that you are creating. You can create multiple startup configurations, and by clicking this, we can enable to which device we are going to push this startup configuration. And the startup configuration, for example, let me say I'm going to push it to my router. When I click this image, it will give me the space to enter my configuration. So I can fill my configuration, router configuration here, and I can tag this configuration to my router. So whenever the router is getting started, the router will come up with the initial configurations that we gave here. Now, apart from these two basic images, let me show you how to add network devices in this lab. You can use file transfer applications like WinSCP, FileZilla. I'm using FileZilla. This is my IP. And use your CLI credential. Now I got connected with my CNET lab machine, and the path is opt unitlab add-ons QEMU. So this is the path. This is where we are going to add our images. I already got a couple of images. I'm just dragging these images to the PNET lab. Yeah, both the images are imported. Coming back to lab, let's check for the node now. I'm refreshing it once. I can see the Cisco images added. Now we can choose our device and we can spin up our instance. When you double click, you will be able to open the HTML console of the device. Now the router is loading. This is how we need to spin up the instance. And before spinning up, make sure your device has enough memory. All these features are available for free. You can use it wisely. Compare with EU Community Edition. It looks promising. Not only Cisco images, even we can work with many of the other network devices, the devices that belongs to various network vendors. Let's explore this documentation. Here you can see the hardware requirement. The minimum requirement is 8 GB, but if you have the device with 16 GB or 32 GB, then you will be able to work with larger labs. You can able to add more number of devices in the lab. Also, you can use some high-end devices like Nexus switches, checkpoint firewalls, ICE, and the Palo Alto firewalls. So we can use those devices. And let's see the PNET lab supported images. These are all the images that we can bring into this PNET lab, and we can do labbing. It almost consists every device. You can also bring your Kali Linux into it, and you can use it for penetration testing. It almost consists every image similar to EventG. The image you can bring by using the file transfer applications like I shown before. I hope this will be very helpful to you to form your lab. I think I gave everything I had, and yes, that's all I've got. I hope you liked this video. If you did, consider subscribing my channel. You can like this video and you can share this video among your friends who are trying to build the lab. I'll see you another day with another exciting video. Until then, signing off. Bye.